Good evening, everybody. Today we can go to the fifth module, and there we can first go to the second poem, second lesson, and that is a poem. It is written by the famous English writer W. H. Auden. And as you have gone through page number 153, the title you can see Refugee Blues. So in the fifth module, we are generally talking about refugee issues, how the refugees are facing so many problems in another foreign country. You may know who a refugee is: due to war or due to death threat or something like that. Already we have seen in the previous module, we have seen Salman Rushdie had to go to another country as a refugee. So similarly, due to some reason, people are forced to go to in another foreign land, and so what are the problems they have to face there? So in this lesson, Refugee Blues, we are going to see about the problems of Jewish people, Jews under the Hitler's regime. So when Hitler became the ruler of Germany, and his main aim was to destroy all the Jewish people, kill all the Jewish people, so many thousands of Jewish people were killed by Adolf Hitler. So many such Jewish people living in Germany, they wanted to escape from Hitler's such a brutal killing and all. So they went to different foreign countries. So when they went there, and what were their feelings, or how the people in that foreign country treated them, whether they have got any consideration, care, etc., it is described in this particular lesson. And the more details you can see in the second paragraph, and there already the ideas are already given, and this poem is written in 1933, and also it is included in 10 songs by W. H. Auden, and also in throughout the lesson we can see "my dear," that word is used as a refrain. Refrain means a particular line or a single word. It is repeatedly using in the same lesson. That is a refrain. "My dear," it is repeated. And also you can see what is the problem here. Focusing problem is given here. And here the poet and also his companion, they escaped to a foreign country as a refugees. And when they went there, and they thought their life would be very safe, but they had to face so many insecurities there, so many problems there, and many people, they didn't accept them as humans, and they dismissed them, and also they had a misunderstanding about the poet and his companion, and all these things we can see. And also he has lost his own home, because when he went to this foreign country, they were unable to renew their passport, so they lost their actual home. They can't go back to their country, and also they lost their freedom, because now they are not in their own country, they are in another country. So they lost their freedom, and as they lost their passport, or as they can't renew their passport, even their identity also they lost. And all these things you can see, because their passport is already expired. And all these things you can see in the lesson. So when we come to the lesson, you can go through each stanza. When you come to the first stanza, the speaker says, the city in which they are living, it contains so many millions of people. So all refer to the people living in that foreign country. And some people in that foreign country, they are living in big houses or mansions, and some are living in very unpleasant situations, like a slum in many places. Even in our India, in Mumbai, you know, so many slums are there. So such people are there living in this particular city. So either they have a big house, mansions, or they have a particular place to live in, whether it is a hall or a mansion. But look at the third line of the first stanza there. The speaker is lamenting, and they have no place to live. The people in the city has any kind of home is there, a mansion or a hall, but they have no place to live in. And when we come to the second stanza, now the speaker is very sad in thinking about his own country. And so he is telling that we had a country. That means now they do not on a country. Once upon a time they had a country and it was a fair country, and now the speaker is looking at the atlas. Atlas, you know what it is. And when they are looking upon the atlas, they can find out their own home, but they can't go to that particular place. It is only remaining on the atlas. And so with a great sadness and disappointment, the speaker is telling, we are unable to go there. We can see it only in the atlas. And when you come to the third stanza, and he is remembering, very sadly he is remembering about the churchyard, the yard of the church. And also in front of that church, an old yew tree is there. Yew tree is already given in your glossary. It is a coniferous tree, like a pine, like a Christmas tree or something like that. And so every spring season, this yew tree will be covered with blossom. That means every spring, the tree is renewed again and again, becoming new and new, with the full of blossoms, flowers. But the third line is telling, old passports can't do that. So here old passport means the passports of the speaker and his the poet and his companion, and they were unable to renew their passport, so it already became very old. So old passports cannot becoming new, like a yew tree is becoming new after every spring, on every spring. So already, because their passport is already expired, it cannot be renewed once again, so they lost everything. And when you